As the year's coming to a close, it's a great time to get a jump start on next year's budget. So today we're going to be sharing some strategies to help you start your budget and save money. Hi, I'm Joseph.
And I'm Tasha with One Big Happy Life, and we help you find balance, build wealth, and live happy. Everything you need to create the life that you want.
Okay, so we're hoping by now that you're familiar a little bit with budgeting. Hopefully you had a budget this year. But now that this year's coming to an end, we definitely want to get you ready for 2020. So let's get our budgeting tools together and talk about how you can get your budget started and incorporate some savings in it.
And speaking of helping you get ready for 2020, we are doing a free money challenge right at the beginning of January, the Rock Your Year 2020 Challenge. You should definitely join us. Head on over to onebighappylife.com/rock2020, and we're going to start the year off right together.
So the first part about budgeting that is just absolutely crucial is getting your mind right about budgeting. A lot of times, just the concept of budgeting can have this negative connotation. And so we don't want you to have that. We want you to think of budgeting and think of it positively because it is such a useful tool.
When it comes to your finances, it's really important to recognize that whatever you've done in the past, you don't have to blame or shame yourself for it. Those are your decisions. You made them. We're here now. So you can start focusing on what you can do to pivot and improve your finances going forward. So going into this with a positive mindset and with giving yourself some grace will make it so much easier for you to make financial decisions that truly align with who you are now and where you want to go instead of focusing exclusively in the past. Also, keep in mind that when it comes to budgeting, now a lot of people like to think of budgeting as restrictive, and so they like to avoid it at all costs. But what we do is we encourage you to think about budgeting as a way of using your money to create the exact life that you want, because we live in a world where just about every single decision that we make has some kind of price tag attached to it, whether it's where we live or where we choose to work or our line of work or even the clothing that we wear. So think of your budget as basically your life, but measured in dollars. Okay. So the rest of this, we're going to be going through how you can make sure that you're creating a budget/spending plan that aligns with the life that you truly want to live.
As you're creating your spending plan, you want to decide what you want your life to look like. So what kinds of things are important to you that you want to include in it, and what things you don't really like right now and you don't want to prioritize by allocating your dollars to it. So give this a lot of thought because, you know, whatever you plan in your spending plan, following that, you know, that's going to dictate how you feel about your life in the next year.
And when you connect your budget to what you actually want out of life, then it makes it easier for you to make your financial decisions that will give you what you want to have, because you know that you actually already decided you didn't want to spend more than, say, $400 eating out a month. You wanted to have that $400 eating out, and then you wanted, say, another $300 to go towards a vacation fund. So then when your friends are like, oh, well, do you want to eat out again? Or your kids are like, Mom, can we eat out? You're like, oh, well, honey, no, because we already made this decision, and now I want to make sure that we're able to go to Disney later this year. You know, so the trade-offs are so much easier to make.
Next, after you have your ideal life in mind, it's time to go ahead and create your one-year spending plan. Which, of course, if you don't already plan a full year in advance, we definitely recommend it. And we have a free template at our website, onebighappylife.com/budget. And so you can use that template to build your first one-year spending plan. Now, we recommend the one-year spending plan because it helps lots of different things, including like planning for longer-term goals across the year. If you're just doing month by month, it's a lot harder to say, oh, save $6,000 over the next 12 months. You got to remember to have that. And then sometimes your expenses hit in different months of the year, and that's really hard to juggle all of that. If you put it together in an entire year's worth of planning, you can see where those things are going to hit, and then make adjustments throughout the entire year to accommodate it.
Plus, a one-year spending plan really puts your spending into perspective and, you know, helps you decide, well, do I really want to be spending all of this for an entire year on this thing when I could be spending it on something else? Whereas if you're just looking month to month or paycheck by paycheck, it's really hard to see where all of your money is going. And here's the thing, whether you have it down on paper or not, you absolutely have a one-year budget, because no matter what, the next year and you're is going to unfold the way it's going to unfold financially. So wouldn't you rather see what's coming than to like have a fog that's only like 2 weeks ahead where you have no idea what's on the other side? Trust us on this. And it is super easy to implement a one-year spending plan. We're going to be sharing our budget later on this week, our 2020 budget, so you can stay tuned for that for sure. But definitely go ahead and get the template from onebighappylife.com/budget and go through it and fill it out. And we also have a video that shows you how to create your one-year spending plan, and I'll drop that down below.
Next, you want to identify your minimum expenses and your budget surplus. So you're going to need to get together all of your bank statements, all of your credit card statements, your utility bills, everything that you're paying, and lay it all out to see what you have been doing. And that's really going to help you with the baseline of your budget, figure out the most important things, the things that you have to do, rent, food, you know, the most important things, and then seeing how much budget surplus you have to then play around with and prioritize what else you're interested in. And so you can see the kinds of things that you have been spending money on, which is great to flag things that you no longer want to spend money on, because you start looking at it and say, oh my gosh, I'm paying, you know, this much for this subscription, a streaming service or something like that, that you're not really using. Well, hey, then you definitely want to not include that moving forward.
So now that you know what your minimum monthly expenses are and what your budget surplus is, you know how much you are working with to hit your lifestyle goals. But we want you to right off the bat commit to always saving at least some small portion of your income every single month. No matter how small it is, it's really important to start developing a savings habit, because savings is absolutely essential. And we know that you hear a lot of advice out there that tells you that you can't save money if you have debt and you shouldn't save money if you have debt. That is false. We have debunked this money myth so many times. Having some amount of cushion to help protect you in financial emergencies is essential. So having a 3-month emergency fund is huge, but also saving for retirement, putting aside money for your financial future is so incredibly important. And it can be a bit of a challenge to develop a savings habit. Whereas paying off debt, that's something that you're already used to, seeing your money go away. What you're not necessarily used to is seeing your money build, sitting there and just not touching it. And it takes time to build that habit. So we want you to commit to starting right now, even if it's just $5 a paycheck, and then commit to increasing that amount over time.
As you're building your budget, look for ways that you can cut your expenses to really get those things that are important to you in your budget. So, you know, take a look at the things that you haven't really been working for you the past year, and then make sure that you're getting the biggest priorities, the things that you find the most fun, incorporated into that budget while still leaving some room for those savings.
And we're not going to say that you need to be uber frugal or that you have to cut out all the things that you love in order to hit your other financial goals. Absolutely not. But we do recognize that a lot of us have some waste in our budget, that when we really start looking at how we're spending our money, we're like, you know what? I actually prefer not to spend, like I prefer to have this money to use it for this instead of what I've been using it for, right? So it's sort of being more conscious and intentional with how you're using your money. But also we recognize that we are huge advocates of increasing your income rather than living down to your current income, grow your income up to the lifestyle that you want to have. But the reality is that it takes time to grow your income. So being able, looking at your expenses is a quick way to start making some big moves on your financial goals while you are working on also growing your income.
Yeah, and cutting those expenses might be able to free up some cash to be able to make an investment in, say, some training, some education that can then ultimately lead to you pulling in the higher salary that you want and need to support your financial priorities.
Next up, we want you to create a debt payoff plan. So chances are, if you are like most people, you have some amount of debt. And I just want to say this upfront, you do not need to rapidly pay off your debt. You don't need to sacrifice everything to pay it off. You can choose to pay off your debt in a more gradual way. And yes, that might mean that you're going to pay some amount more in interest, but we're also talking about the time of your life that you're going to be paying off this debt. So don't discount your life and the present value of your time by saying that I'm going to sacrifice a whole year of my life and do nothing just so that I can save a couple hundred dollars worth of interest, you know? So that's why we say, make sure that you are thinking of that balance, right? It's okay to take an extra 6 months or a year to pay off your debt if it means that you can also enjoy the journey along the way.
Yeah, it's way more important that you can create the plan that you can stick to until that debt is paid off. Because making a plan that you don't like the interim, so you don't like how your life is because you've cut yourself back so much, and then you break your mold and then, you know, binge spend or just don't want to look at it and end up spending too much money. And then you start getting in that cycle where, you know, you're too aggressively cutting expenses to pay off your debt, but then you get upset with it. And so it's so much more important and to be successful to have a plan that you can live with in the long run.
All right. And then lastly, to make this as simple as possible, you have your 1 year spending plan, you've planned for your savings, you have that debt payoff plan, and you're looking to grow your income. So to keep this plan going and to put it on autopilot, you want to automate your finances. So that means set your bills on auto pay. And one of the easiest ways to automate your finances is to get 1 month ahead on your bills. So you're not waiting for money to come in so you can pay bills. This month's bills are already taken care of with last month's income. Okay. And so then automate your finances, automate your savings. And then after that, all you have to do is work on making sure that your day-to-day habits are in alignment with the life and the financial plan that you've already decided that you wanted.
All right. Good luck with budgeting for 2020. Let us know in the comments how that's going for you. And make sure you tune in for our video where we talk about our 2020 budgets.
All right. See you guys next time. Bye.
Bye. We'll be chilling and having a good time.